na taga sa akin, my older brother died after 18 months with lung cancer. Pero po, yung kaibigan ng kanyang anak, pareho po sila medical doctor, and they were the ones who took care of my brother. Sinabi sa akin, your brother did not die of the cancer. He died because the chemo destroyed his kidneys.
Ayun. They died of malnutrition. Yung mga iba kasi hindi na nakakakain.
80% die of starvation.
Ayan. Yeah. Kaya nangangayayat eh. Yes. Kaya nakikita nyo, ay naku, nangangayayat. Because, so, again, alam nyo po yung chemotherapy. Ano yan eh, lason?
Well, there was 17,000 stage 4 cancer study done in California, and the findings were that the 5-year survival rate for chemo was 6%. Nung nakita ko yan, sabi ko, talaga hindi ako pupunta dyan. The odds are against me.
Okay.
And ngayon po, the American Cancer Society has issued a statement.
Okay.
Na kung may cancer ka, if you do nothing at all, your survival rate with good quality of life is 8 to 10 years.
Okay, doing nothing, ha?
Doing nothing.
No chemo.
Nothing.
Oh.
Pero no chemo, no biopsy, no nothing.
Okay.
Okay?
Sir, let's jump into this. Ano? Malapit na tayo matapos. Let's jump into this, yung findings po, yung doktor, kung paano po kayo ginamot yung prostate nyo and how it can help other people.
Well, Dr. Kelly found that, first of all, it's injuries to tissues that trigger cancer.
Okay.
Yeah? Secondly, the cancer develops because the person is already deficient in digestive enzymes.
Mm-hmm.
That's why, anong malaman mo you're deficient in digestive enzymes? Dighay ka ng dighay, utot ka ng utot. That means you cannot digest your food anymore and the undigested food is fermenting, generating the gas. And Dr. Kelly said, if you are deficient in digestive enzymes, the cancer will develop. The injuries to tissues will develop. So what he did to cure himself, because he was 1.5 months terminal with pancreatic cancer, the most deadly of all. He cured himself in 18 months and survived for the next 43 years. What he did was he filled himself up with mega doses of pancreatic digestive enzymes.
Yung po ba yung ano ng baboy?
Yung lapay ng baboy.
Okay. That's exactly what he used? I mean, fresh...
Yes. No, I did not use the fresh, I used the capsules. Because at that time, the exchange rate was such that in pesos, it was still affordable.
Okay, apo.
But in 1997, when Thailand had its economic meltdown, our exchange rate went up 40, 50, 60 to the dollar. And the $2,000 a month that was costing me for the Kelly protocol had now become $100,000, but still cheaper than chemo, but it's now expensive. A lot of people could not afford it. So one morning I was calling Dr. Kelly, 4 o'clock in the morning. I said, people here are dying because they can no longer afford your enzymes.
Mm-hmm.
Can you not bring the price down? He said, no, it's because of raw materials. It's very high. Raw materials. Nandun yung bote niya sa harap ko, it said, made from porcine sources.
Mm.
Dr. Kelly, ano ba itong porcine sources?
Pig.
Pigs. Ay, Dr. Kelly, we have a lot of pigs in the Philippines. What if I give them raw pork pancreas? Sabi niya, that will work.
Mm.
Sabi ko, give me the dosage. He gave me the dosage. Mm. That takes away $1,300 from the $2,000.
Mm.
Sabi ko, Dr. Kelly, all we have to worry about is the $700. I remember you were eating raw beef liver when you were curing yourself. Okay. What was that for? Sabi niya, it's the richest in vitamins and minerals. It's the best blood builder there is.
Raw.
Beef liver.
Okay.
Sabi ko, well, in that case, why don't I give him raw beef liver?
Oh.
And not, never mind the multivitamin mineral capsules.
Oh, nandun na eh.
Yeah, nandun na. Sabi niya, yes, that will work. I said, give me dosage. So he gave me the dosage again. Sabi ko, Dr. Kelly, you know, if this works, we will have found the cure for cancer for the poor in the Philippines.
Mm.
He said, no, you are wrong. If this works, you will have found the cure for the poor throughout the world for cancer. I said, well, what do we do now? What's the next step? He said, the next step, look for someone who's willing to eat the raw pork pancreas and the raw beef liver.
Uh-huh.
And luckily, that same week,
uh-huh.
a man came from Malasiki, Pangasinan, all the way. He borrowed the municipal ambulance, arrived at my house at 7:30 in the morning
uh-huh.
with a suero stand in a nurse and his wife.
Uh-huh.
And he was very gloomy. While he was eating breakfast, his wife said, he says he's ready to go uh-huh. because four doctors have told him that he has 4 months to live.
Sinintensya na.
Sabi ko, pangalan niya Jaime din. Sabi ko, Jaime, you made a mistake. You should have seen 10 doctors. Your wife have told you you have 10 months to live. That's the first time he has laughed in months. I said, give him 1,000 jokes a day, so he'll be laughing all the time. He found Dr. Terry's book in my house. He browsed through it. My gosh, he got filled with hope. Sabi niya doon sa nurse niya, umuwi ka na, take the ambulance with you, take the suero with you. Sabi ko, how will you go home? Magkukumita lang ako. I called Dr. Carmencita Yap, who was then the president of PICAM, and said, can you manage this fellow with the rope pliers and the roller? Sabi niya, I don't know about that. I said, I'll tell you what it's all about. She said, yes, after which saw her, yes, I'll do it. So the fellow went back to Malaysia.